What will be the new nuclear fission technology we will use in the future? A possible answer to this question is represented by two liquid metal fast breeder reactors, the sodium and the lead cooled fast reactor. These two nuclear systems were selected by Generation 4 International Forum among the most promising nuclear concepts for our future. In its technological roadmap, the Forum defined four goal areas to advance nuclear energy into its next fourth generation. Sustainability, which requires the conservation of resources and preservation of the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Another goal is aimed at safety and reliability. Generation 4 system must be designed so that safety margins are adequate, accidents are prevented, and off-normal situations do not deteriorate into severe accidents. Advanced nuclear system should be competitive with alternative energy options from an economic point of view. Proliferation resistance and physical protection are also essential priorities in order to prevent the use of civilian nuclear energy systems for nuclear weapon proliferation. Besides lead-cooled fast reactor and sodium-cooled fast reactor, the other concepts selected by the Generation 4 International Forum are the gas-cooled fast reactor, the molten salt reactor, the supercritical water-cooled reactor, and the very high-temperature reactor. Sodium-cooled fast reactors are not a new concept. The use of liquid sodium was taken into account as coolant in the framework of the liquid metal fast breeder reactors due to the high power density, the low doubling time, and the good compatibility with the structural materials. Sodium fast reactors have been built and operated in US, France, Soviet Union, India, and also Japan. The successful operation of the experimental breeder reactor 2 in the US from 1964 to 1994 paved the way for sodium to become the reference coolant of fast neutron reactors. As for commercial power reactor, good experience came from Phoenix in France and BN-600 in Russia. The SFR system has several good properties. A low melting point ensures a good margin to boiling and the possibility to operate near atmospheric pressure, and hence there is no need for a pressurizer component. A high thermal capacity grants large thermal inertia in case of accidents. Low density allows for a small pumping power, and the good thermal conductivity increases the heat exchange between cladding and coolant. The good compatibility with material and sodium, along with the gain experience, makes the SFR technology more mature than other fast reactor technologies. The good neutronics features offer the possibility for a best use of limited nuclear fuel resources, considering a closed fuel cycle. In addition, its fast neutron spectrum enables minor actinide recycling. However, there are some issues with the use of sodium that need further investigation. As the exothermic reactions with water and air, which impact on the reactor design. The use of an intermediate heat exchanger, non-water energy conversion systems, and oxygen and hydrogen control can mitigate this issue. The coolant activation makes shielding more challenging. The low boiling point, along with the possible positive void feedback coefficient, can be problematic from the safety point of view. Provisions in order to avoid and mitigate this aspect should be considered. The opacity of the sodium can be troublesome for the inspection of the in-vessel reactor components and maintenance. SFR is the reference system for fast reactor in Europe. In particular, the efforts are devoted to development of ASRID, a pool-type sodium-cooled fast reactor with a thermal power of about 1,500 MW. Other projects related to the SFR are ongoing in Russia, US, Japan and South Korea, focusing on both small and large power reactors. Also, lead-cooled fast reactors are not a new concept. In the Western world, during the 50s, fast spectrum systems with molten lead or lead bismuth alloy were initially considered, but they were discarded due to the corrosion problem of the lead. Notwithstanding, in the Soviet Union, the lead bismuth eutectic was used as coolant for nuclear reactor for submarine propulsion. In the recent years, there was a renewal of interest for this technology, both for critical and the subcritical reactors. Lead is a coolant with favorable thermal, chemical and neutronics features. The high boiling point of lead reduces the risk of core voiding. The high density contributes to fuel dispersion instead of compaction in case of core melting. The high thermal capacity provides large thermal inertia in case of loss of heat sink accident. There is no exothermic reaction between lead and water or air, meaning that there is no need for an intermediate heat exchanger. The low neutron moderation allows great spacing between fuel pins. The large space between the pins leads to a lower cross-pressure drops, which also allows natural convection cooling, and it also helps in reducing the risk of flow blockage. Other advantages of lead consist in its good shielding properties and the possibility to employ a closed fuel cycle with an efficient conversion of fertile uranium and minor actinides management. On the other hand, there are also some drawbacks of the lead coolant. The corrosion due to the use of the lead-based alloy, which calls for coolant chemical control, cladding coating, new materials, and purification technique. The erosion issue limits the lead velocity around 2 m per second. The high melting point arises the problem of the solidification of the lead. Special provisions are foreseen in order to avoid this issue. The opacity of the lead can be troublesome for the inspection of the in-vessel reactor components and for maintenance. The high density of the lead has an impact on the mechanical design, in particular in case of an earthquake, and for refueling. Research is underway to apply seismic isolator to the LFR. Several projects are currently under development, focusing on lead-cooled fast reactor. In particular, Europe is doing research on two main systems. MIRA, an accelerator-driven system cooled by lead bismuth eutectic devoted to isotope production, material testing, and fundamental research. ALFRED, a reactor with a thermal power of 300 MW, cooled by pure lead, intended for electrical power generation. Other projects related to the LFR are ongoing in Russia, Sweden, China, South Korea, and US. Sodium and the lead-cooled reactors are a very promising concept for the next generation of nuclear reactor. Thanks to the sodium and the lead physical, thermal, chemical and neutronics favorable features, these liquid metal fast breeder reactors can ensure strong improvement in sustainability, safety and reliability, economics, proliferation resistance and physical protection. SFR and LFR have a great potential. However, they introduce additional research and development challenges in safety, design and materials that can be faced also thanks to scientific joint activities and education and training programs.